You see they touch hands, they're like, hey, good, good. I mean, they don't do it as much now, obviously, Skip, because of COVID. But, you know, pre-COVID, you walking up the tunnel, and, you know, the players are slapping hands. And that was a cool thing. But
It's a great part of the game experience for an NBA fan. You can literally reach out and touch.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And yet you could reach out and dump or throw or what you can do yes. whatever you want from those. But you're going to have a security guard, like, quote unquote, 24 hours. You're going to have them up there because Russ left with, I think there was 10 minutes left in the game.
Right.
So it wasn't at the end of the game, as we're talking about usually. It was fairly early in the fourth quarter. You need a guard up there to watch that they're protected as they walk up the tunnel.
Have a guard up there to watch grown people to make sure they don't do childish things.
I got it. I also sense a new outpouring. We have all been trapped in our homes for God knows how long,
right.
over a year, right?
Right.
We've been quarantined,
mm-hmm.
and I'm feeling this sort of joyful freedom that everybody,
yes.
as they go back to the arenas, and
right.
if you saw the end of the PGA tournament the other
right.
day, on
it
18,
crazy.
It was just a mob scene because the security got overwhelmed.
Right.
And everybody is so happy. That's obviously outside.
Right.
I saw very few masks, but everybody was free.
Right.
And they were going crazy, and they probably had some beer, you know, a lot.
Oh, yeah, that
a little too much
right,
beer
right,
over
right,
the.
Right.
It's a long, hot day out
yes.
there at Kiowa.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, they're just storming the palace on 18, man.
Yes.
They're everywhere. And Phil Mickelson and his caddy and Brooks Koepka and his caddy got trapped in the mob
right.
scene. And especially Koepka, who just had his knee
right.
scoped.
Mm-hmm.
He's getting hit, and he said he got banged in the knee a couple
right.
of times. So this is, but it's like a joyful overreaction
right.
of people who are so happy to be free again.
Skip, and in that situation, Skip, they're not trying to disrespect these guys. They're just so happy.
Yes.
He was not happy that Russell's walking
no,
again. He
that
did that out
different.
Of disrespect.
That,
right. And so in the golf situation, that's totally different. Now, I get it, you know, and I think a lot of that had to do with Phil, because Phil is still a fan favorite, and he was going to win. And so this is my opportunity to get close. Close and touching.
And Koepka was the wrestling villain all day. Trust me
yeah.
on that.
So, okay. Exactly.
Okay, so they were pro Phil, and it looked like Phil had it wrapped up because he just hit his second shot right in the middle of the green on 18, so it's virtually over.
Right.
Okay, he's going to have 3 putts to win the championship.
Correct.
Okay, so they were ecstatic.
Mm-hmm.
They were losing their minds. This is different, but the two greatest viewing experiences in sports are in a golf tournament where you can reach out and touch,
right.
you have great access.
Right.
You can be anywhere. You can
right.
get right up to the shot making,
right.
you know, especially when they hit it in the rough.
Yeah.
You can just get right up. You're within, you could reach out and grab his club as he's
even a tee box, Skip, the guys are, the people
right there.
Are right, they're right,
right
there.
There. Same for an NBA game, because especially if you pay for courtside.
Yes.
And I have sat at courtside mm-hmm. for years and years at the press
mm-hmm.
table. You can smell the smells,
yeah.
not only the popcorn, you can about smell the sweat.
Yes.
And for a fan in the front row or the second row, you can see everything.
Yes.
You can hear the trash talk. Obviously, they're wearing tank tops and shorts,
right.
so it's right there.
Right.
It's you feel like you're in the middle of the action,
yep.
which brings us to the Knicks. It's been years since they've even been in the playoffs. And again, New York is starting to feel free again, and it was the original target of COVID. COVID hit the hardest
mm-hmm.
in New York
mm-hmm.
first, it
yep.
felt like, right?
It did.
And all of a sudden, everybody's out, they're walking Madison Avenue again, and they're going to the Garden. And it was fairly packed last night. A lot of people did have on masks. Spike Lee had on a mask.
Mm-hmm.
But they were just blissful that their Knicks have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
They look like a good, like they got a real chance of beating the Hawks. It's probably going to go seven.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And they're actually in the arena again, and it feels great. But now we get a guy who had on a Knicks shirt, and it looks like he's in the second row.
Right.
And all of a sudden, as little Trae Young is inbounding the basketball, he winds up and spits over the shoulder of a woman who flinches
oh, yes.
in the front row.
You flinches. Saw that too,
she
huh?
She can see it, yeah. And I don't think Trae knew what happened because it's just spit from behind
right.
and it landed.
Right.
I assume it hit him in the back of the shoulder or on the back
Woo.
Of the arm. Okay?
Jesus.
Ultimate act of disrespect. You're amped up, you're fueled up, and you lose your mind and go completely over the edge. Well, this is the one that I don't know how to fix. You're either going to sell courtside or you're not. You're
right.
going to put up plexiglass?
Right.
I mean, are we heading there? We had foul ball plexiglass that had to be put up for baseball protection.
Yeah, the netting.
Right?
Skip, no, I just think the thing, man, for me, I just don't get that, Skip. I just don't get it. And I understand, Skip, fan short for fanatic. And a lot of these people have been fans with their particular team since they were infants.
They were.
Their parents were fans and their grandfather. And I get all that, Skip. But when did it become okay to be disrespectful? Because the thing is that you try to always remember, that's somebody's son or that's someone's daughter. So if someone would have spit on your son or your daughter, how would you feel? If someone would have dumped popcorn on your son or your daughter, how would you feel? But, man, if Trey, that had been me and I knew it, oh, it would have took Congress, mm-hmm. Act of Congress and 10,000 soldiers to keep me off his ass.
Okay.
The spittle, Skip, do you understand the level of disrespect that you have for someone just to do that? I mean, the level of disrespect, so you just lost all respect. I got nothing for you, bro.
Mm.
Nothing. I disrespect you. I hate you that much. And like Russ said, it's getting more and more because what are the ramifications, Skip?
Yep.
The punishment needs to be so severe that you deter future reference. That's originally what punishment was instituted for.
Yep.
Punishment was not instituted for the perpetrator, but also to deter others from doing said acts.
Yep. I'm pretty sure the video will identify that fan in the second row, and I'm guessing they will know who possessed those tickets.
Right.
And that they can ban that fan because that's complete banishment.
Or maybe they brought them. Maybe they brought somebody that they belong to somebody.
Maybe.
And you know what I'm saying, Skip? Well, guess what? You're responsible for it, Skip.
Yep.
You do. That's how it works. If those are my tickets, and if I let my cousin or my family member get those two tickets, and they act a fool, I'm responsible for those seats.
Hey, I think you're with me. That was even worse than the popcorn.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And that's why, Skip, you know, in football, you know, you get X amount of tickets. And my tickets was always in the same section. I always told them, hey, that's Shannon. Everybody know who sits in those seats. Those have been by my seat since 1990. So you're responsible. Tell my mom, hey, mom, that's somebody's son down there playing on the field.
Yep.
Watch how you talk.
Okay. In football, you're talking to people around you.
Right.
At least you're restrained. You can't go over the wall.
Oh, no.
Right? You can't reach out and touch.
But it's almost like, Skip, you know what it is? They almost know I can't whip a football player. I would never be that disrespectful
to a
football player.
Yep.
So let me try a basketball player because, you know, they slender built. Now, if we had an incident, I hate to mention it, bring it up, but you remember in Denver, that Monday night, that snowball in the Raiders.
Oh, I thought you were going to do Bill Romanowski.
No.
Oh, okay.
With the snow, Lincoln Kennedy was always trying to get up in the stands.
Yep.
But for the most part, like you said, they're so far away, and they already know, 6'6", 300 pounds, I can't beat him. I'm going to better leave him alone.
Right. I mentioned Romanowski because there was it was a launching point for a Super Bowl for your team.
Yes.
But your teammate Bill Romanowski during a Monday night football game spat on J.J. Stokes, who was playing for
49ers.
Mm-hmm. So it's Denver 49ers Monday night football. And I can't remember if you won or lost.
We lost.
You lost.
Yeah,
and then you had some team meetings.
Yeah, we had a come together meeting.
Yes.
And it was the turning point of our season. It could have went the other way. But luckily enough, we had enough strong-minded veteran leadership that we righted the ship, and we...
And he apologized so profusely, you guys finally bought it.
We did.
Yes.
We did. But he and I, even after the meeting, he and I had a sit-down conversation. And I just explained to him, Romo, you have to understand the looks of that, you being white, J.J. Stokes being black, just the appearance.
Ugh.
Forget the level of disrespect, regardless, black to black, white to white. But when it's on the other side, because we've seen that throughout the history.
Yep.
So you just have to understand.
I'm saying
lot of things, you know, appearance has a lot to do with a lot of things, Romo.
Here's the other thing that is just incomprehensible to me. Trey Young is a sweetheart. He's a nice kid, and he's about 5'11", and I don't understand how he became the ultimate villain at MSG Madison Square Garden.
Skip, anybody that's good for the opposing team
is the villain.
And
he's been really good. He was good last night until they finally started to play what they can really play, which is defense.
Right.
And then they just shut down the Hawks in the second half. And I'm not sure the time of this spitting incident, but I'm sure it was – during the comeback for the Knicks, because the Knicks looked down and out for a while.
They did.
And now it's 1-1 going to Atlanta.
But Russ is absolutely right.
Yeah.
Russ is like the NBA. But Skip, sure, like I said, I don't really know what else the NBA can do except when they find out who the perpetrator is, ban them from the arena, whoever is responsible for the arena. So MSG, obviously that'd be James Dolan. You can no longer come into this building. It doesn't matter what the event is being held in the building.
I agree.
You cannot attend.
Right.
And so we're done with that.
They need to get to the bottom of this.
Yes.
They need to do their homework. They need to find out who that fan was. And if they haven't captured the one in Philadelphia, they need to ban him.
And the Sixers, publicly apologize to Russ. New York Knicks, apologize to Trae Young.
Yep.
Because what your fans did is unacceptable. And
yesterday, we even had the mayor of New York taking shots
at little Trae Young.
What?
I know.
Skip, what are you talking about?
Skip Mike used to give us, when we were up in training camp with Greeley, Mike used to give us occasional night off. Alex Gibbs, who was our offensive line coach, he says, don't you be the one to mess it up for everybody else.
Yeah, that's it.
And that's one
that's
fan.
It. Yeah.
And then make it look bad for all the other fans that had a great time and didn't do anything like this.
Right.
One joker.
Yeah. Agree. Almost a PSA. Come on, fans. Be better than this. Be better than this. Because we just got you back in the building, and we've missed you, and it's important. But I hate to have stories like this overshadow what we've been watching, which has been great basketball and great playoff games, including the Lakers. Skip, you know, Magic Johnson. Did he give LeBron just a bit too much credit for the Lakers game to win? And Tim Tebow, maybe he's already having a positive impact with the Jaguars. We got a packed show. It's all coming up.